quiet. It's recording.
I'm not giving. I don't wanna be killed. I'm going to fight. I'm sorry.
All right, we're so unprofessional.
12 fucking foot fucking sex!
Thank you. The other day I heard someone say, you know, America is in real trouble. It's true. Old Glory has never fallen so close to Earth. Our embassies are being stoned. Our diplomats are often in fear for their lives. And we're involved in a half dozen nameless, windless conflicts, spilling American blood on foreign soil. Our young men are dying for ideals which don't seem to mean too much to Americans anymore. The truth is, America's real trouble doesn't lie in the rice paddies of Vietnam, in the masses of Red China, or in the diabolical intrigues to the south of us. The real trouble lies in the playgrounds of St. Louis, the hillside mansions of San Francisco, and in the Chicago slums. The disease which is slowly eating away at the heart of America lies in the small southern towns, the fishing villages of New England, and the hot, dusty streets of the Midwest. This is the age of the American cynic, the year of the unbeliever.
Thank you. Women were attracted to his arrogance. His mama was a slave, and his daddy was a president. Some of his lovers couldn't bear to touch him, but none of them could bear to part. He had a promiscuous body, he had a faithful heart. Before the war, when he was wild and pretty, I met him in a whorehouse up in Kansas City. That's where he'd watch his lover moan with strangers in the dark. She had a promiscuous body, she had a faithful heart. Some of you seek love, some of you merely sex, some of you for an in-between, but none of you found it yet. Some of you recognize good and evil, but he could never tell the two apart. He had a promiscuous body, he had a faithful heart.